Hello everyone, the question we want to answer today is what is the product of a step in the delta function? To answer this question, we need to start from smooth functions. Given smooth functions f and g, we can define the pointwise product, which gives another smooth function. This product satisfies the Leibniz rule. Smooth functions form a vector space, and a vector space equipped with a pointwise multiplication, which is a bilinear map, form an algebra over the field of the real numbers, which is associative, commutative, and satisfies the Leibniz rule. We want to do the same thing with distributions. We want to construct an algebra which is differential, meaning that it satisfies the Leibniz rule. And we want that when we restrict this algebra to usual function, we get a product which is the usual pointwise product. First, prove that if we construct such an algebra, then we can preserve the product for smooth function, but we cannot for function which are not smooth, like for example step functions. This is known as the impossibility result. There are many ways to address product distributions, and one of those are the Colombo algebras. This video is not about Colombo algebras, and there are many versions of them. I'll go through them very quickly just to give you an hint of what they are. We start from a function rho which is smooth, which has integral 1, and from it we set a function rho epsilon. The function rho is called the modifier. If f is a function, then we can define a function f epsilon as the convolution of f with rho epsilon. And if this is a distribution, we can define a function f epsilon, which is the convolution t and rho epsilon. Note that if epsilon goes to 0, rho epsilon goes to delta, f epsilon goes to f or t, depending from which object we started in the first place. E is an algebra of smooth function f epsilon into two variables x and epsilon, and they represent the object we started from on the product. However, in either house object we don't want. When epsilon goes to 0, in a specific interval, a function f epsilon may grow too fast. We know that a delta will grow like epsilon, and a delta prime like epsilon square. So we want to remove all the functions that grow more than polynomially with epsilon going to 0, and we keep what we call the moderate function. We define therefore the subalgebra EM of moderate functions. In the same way, there are functions in E which decay very fast. In specific intervals, for epsilon going to 0, this function decay faster than 1 over a polynomial. When they're multiplied by another function, these functions flatten it and they act like a zero. It's therefore natural to define a set n of this function, which are called null functions. N is an ideal of EM, and therefore it is natural to define the quotient algebra G equal to EM over N, which is the Colombo algebra. We have to say that for the thing to work, modifier should have all momenta equal to zero. Such functions do not exist, but this is not a problem because it can be fixed somehow in the theory. The problem with Colombo algebras is the infinite branching. If we keep multiplying distributions, we get elements in the set which are all different each other, a part of the one that are exactly the same up to permutation terms because the multiplication is commutative. So, for example, the Heaviside function is different from its square and its cube in G, while it is the same function in D prime, the set of temporal distributions. This is due, of course, to the impossibility result. To overcome this problem, Colombo defined the association relation. If we have two distributions, T1 and T2, in the Colombo algebra, we apply the Schwarz function to the difference, which is the integral of the distribution times compact supported functions. If we get zero, we can say that the two distributions can be associated. The difference is a null function in D prime, so they are somehow the same distribution. For example, we can associate the Heaviside function U with its square or its cube. So we can associate these three elements in the algebra G. We now go back to our original question: what is the product of a step and delta function? Well, we have seen that there are infinite many different step functions, and there are infinite many different delta functions. So the result depends on which distribution we multiply. To evaluate the product of a step in a delta function, we will use a reasoning which is not very formal, but it's correct, and it comes from the original book of Colombo. Let G be a smooth function that goes from 0 to 1 in R. The limit for k that goes to infinity of gkx gives a unitary Heaviside step function. If we derive this limit, we get a limit which gives the delta function. As you can see, by multiplying these two limits, we get in turn a limit that gives, as a result, the product of a step function to the n by a delta function. The rest is simple calculus. We see that our limit goes to 0 for every x different from 0. We evaluate the integral of the limit. The integrand is composed of two terms, being the second one, the derivative, or the argument of the first one. The integral is constant and independent from k, so we can drop the limit because the limit of a constant sequence is the constant itself. We see that the integral is finite. We have a distribution which is 0 for x different from 0, and it has finite integral. So we can say that it is a delta of amplitude 1 over n plus 1, which means that u to the n times delta can be associated to a delta of amplitude 1 over n plus 1, according to the criteria we defined before. So we have an algebra of generalized function G. In this algebra, we can associate different step functions, and they correspond to a single step function in the prime. For what we said before, we can also associate product of step and delta function, and they are mapped to a single element in the prime. There are also other elements in G. For example, it is possible to prove that delta square can be associated to the distribution 1 half minus u times delta prime. And this can be mapped to an element in a bigger set V. V is a vector space, not a differential algebra. In V, we lose associativity, and elements of V do not satisfy the Leibniz rule. When we work with distribution, we want always to work in G, and we may project just the final result to the prime by using the criteria of the association. Everything I told you so far comes from the original books of Colombo, written over 30 years ago now. I want to add my personal contribution to the discussion. This part is not present in any book, and therefore you can be sure that what I say is correct. You can stop watching this video now, or you can follow my reasoning, which is quite simple and straightforward, and convince yourself that what I say is correct. We know now what is the product of u to the n times a delta. I think the following question to ask is what is the product of f of u times a delta, where f is, for example, a smooth function. This question is an extension of the previous one, since if we set f of x equal to x to the n, we get the original question. As before, we start from a smooth function g of x that goes from 0 to 1 in R. As before, we can define a limit for k that goes to infinity that gives the unitary step function. And by deriving this limit, we can define a limit that gives for k that goes to infinity the delta function. We then can use these two functions to define a limit which gives as a result the distribution f of u times delta. We have a bit of calculus to do, which is exactly the same as before. We have that the limit for k that goes to infinity goes to 0 for every x different from 0. And if we evaluate the integral of the limit, this is composed of two terms, being the second one, the derivative of the argument of the f function. Once again, we see that the limit is independent from k, so we can drop the limit, because the limit of a constant function is the constant itself. And we get that the result is the integral from 0 to 1 of f of x in the x. This is a finite integral. So, our distribution is equal to 0 for every x different from 0, and it has a finite integral. It is a delta function. We can say that f of u times delta can be associated to a delta function of amplitude equal to the integral from 0 to 1 of f of x dx. We see that if we set f of x equal x to the n, which is the previous case studied by Colombo, we get a product of distribution which can be associated to a delta of amplitude 1 over n plus 1. And therefore, our equation is coherent with the theory developed by Colombo. To recap, we have that f of u times delta can be associated to a delta function, the amplitude of which can be easily evaluated. And doing a similar reasoning, we can also give an equation for the multidimensional case. Regarding f, we said f should be smooth. Actually, it is possible to show that for the whole thing to work, it is enough for f to be locally integrable. We give now some examples. We set sine of x to be minus 1 plus 2 u of x. This is a distribution which is equal to minus 1 for x negative, and then it has a jump of 2 in 0. With this definition, we can define the delta to be 1 half of sine prime of x, and we get u prime of x, which is the original definition of the delta in G, and this is the delta we want. Now, sine of x is equal to f of u, with f of x equal to minus 1 plus 2x. We want to evaluate the product sine of x times delta. We use our formula to associate this distribution to a delta in D prime, and we get 0. Note that this product, although it can be associated to the zero constant function in D prime, is a very different distribution. If we multiply it for another distribution in general, we get a result which is different from 0. For example, if we multiply again by sine of x, we get sine square of x times delta. Sine square of x is a function which is equal to 1 everywhere, and it is not defined in 0, and therefore it can be associated to the one constant function in D prime. We project again this product in D prime using our formula, and we get that the result is a delta of amplitude 1/3. Finally, we define a function 1 of x, which is, once again, a function which is equal to 1 everywhere, it is not defined in 0. So this function is very similar to the previous one. We want to evaluate this product. And once again, we get that this product can be associated to a delta in D prime of amplitude given by this number here. Note that sine square of x, 1 of x, and 1 can be associated in G. They are the same distribution in D prime. They are not even step discontinuous functions because there is no jump in 0. However, when we multiply them for a delta, we get a completely different result. For more information, go to one of those links. Thanks for watching.